How'd you do? I see you've met my faithful hand in hand.
Richard O'Brien, it is a great honor and pleasure to be talking to you, sir. How are you doing?
I'm fine, thank you so much. I'm in the spring of youth, I am.
Aren't you just? In the city of churches, no less, celebrating quite a milestone for this crazy little show of yours, yeah?
Yes, we are. It's 50 years this year, and I don't know how that happened. Time is fleeting.
It's astounding. Time is fleeting.
Makes no sense whatsoever. It is just a little bit of silly, childish nonsense that's gone on so long.
It's just a jump to the left. With your hands on your hips.
So take us back, Richard. You wrote the show. It was only supposed to go for 3 weeks. It's still going. And then the movie, which of course is a hit in its own right? The Rocky Horror Picture Show. They still have midnight screenings and whatnot. Tell me about making that leap from the stage to the screen.
One of the greatest things was that it was a fringe theatre event, and we were allowed to make a motion picture. The money was coming from 20th Century Fox. We were all allowed to play our original parts in the movie, and our director was also allowed to direct the movie. This is very unusual. The only insistence from Fox was that we cast two Americans in the Brad and Janet roles.
If there's one fool for you, then I am it. Janet. I've one thing to say, and that's damn it, Janet, I love you.
How has it changed? How has the show evolved and changed over the years?
Not too much at all, because if it ain't broke, don't fix it. The most obvious changes are the things that once were a little bit taboo are no longer that way.
I'm just a sweet transvestite.
I guess every cast, obviously, every Frankenfurter, every narrator puts a bit of themselves into it, right?
That's a truth. And of course, many of our raters are kind of famous or well-known in their own sphere of work. So they also bring that with them as well. There's, you know, if they are a cake maker, for instance, we're going to get lots of recipes during the evening.
You've got a wonderful Frankenfurter there in Adelaide who's no stranger to the role. In fact, you've worked with David in the past, right?
He's a triple Olivier Award winner, and he's one of those professionals that delivers big time.
Madness takes its toll.
I've always thought it must be hard for riffraffs to leap into that role that you created so magnificently in the movie.
Well, I'm a hard act to follow there, Richard, you know what I mean?
You are a very hard act to follow.
I remember doing the time warp, drinking those moments when the black pit would hit me and the boy would be calling.
There's a lot of fun playing the Igor role, and playing the resentful butler. There's a lot of pleasure to be had from that.
Richard, put modesty to one side. This young lad from New Zealand, from remote New Zealand, comes up with this idea, and now people are still dressing in the roles. They know every word of your script. What's the secret?
I don't have an answer. I wish I did. There's something liberating about this show. It's undemanding. It allows you to have a good time and dress up.
Do you have a favourite bit in the show? Favourite line or something that still puts a wry smile on your face?
It's not easy having a good time.
It's not easy having a good time.
You've been allowing people to have a good time for 50 years, Richard. It's a great honour and a pleasure to talk to you, mate.
Thank you, Richard.